The prevention of the cornea from drying during cataract surgery is important in maintaining the visibility of the anterior chamber and safely performing the surgery. Normally, I have my assistant apply perfusate at constant intervals. At a training institution like our hospital, however, the assistant frequently changes and falls out of synchronization with me. In fact, I sometimes experience sudden difficulties during the surgery. The position of the lens barrel of the microscope for the assistant must be changed depending on the direction of approach. It really takes time and labor. One solution is automatic titration by attaching an IV set to the microscope. For the deep-set eye, however, the trouble remains unchanged because water is pooled and makes it difficult to see. Viscoelastic material is commonly applied between the contact lens and cornea at vitreous surgery. In recent years, Arshinoff's proposed soft shell technique has become widely used. In this technique, a dispersive viscoelastic material is pressed against the corneal endothelium using a cohesive viscoelastic material in order to protect the corneal endothelium. This creates a layer of the dispersive viscoelastic material in the endothelium. As mentioned in the report by McDermott et al., it was verified that the dispersive viscoelastic material, viscote, was retained on the corneal endothelium after perfusion and aspiration during PEA. This video picture demonstrates that the layer of viscote remains on the corneal endothelium in a larger amount than any other viscoelastic material. The moisturizing action of sodium hyaluronate and sodium chondroitin sulfate, which are components of viscote, are well known. If a dispersive viscoelastic material is applied to the corneal endothelium so that it becomes a uniform layer, as in the soft shell technique, I believe that the material is similarly difficult to remove from the corneal endothelium and prevents the cornea from drying and clouding. In other words, if cataract surgery is performed after you have ensured that the applied viscote has uniformly covered the entire cornea, the visibility of the anterior chamber and lens can be maintained without additionally wetting the cornea throughout the whole surgical process. If you additionally coat viscote to the incisional wound of the cornea before finishing the surgery, you can be sure that more certain self-closure of the wound can be expected. I name this method the wet shell technique and report it. Coat the cornea with viscote and drop an ophthalmic anesthetic and perfusate onto the applied viscote. Although the corneal surface is rough immediately after viscote has been applied, the perfusate will make it smooth and a uniform layer of viscote will cover the entire surface. Immediately, good visibility can be obtained. Viscote will be so firmly fixed to the cornea that it cannot be easily washed off. The part washed with perfusate is temporarily depressed, but immediately becomes uniform again. The visibility of the anterior capsule will be maintained without dropping perfusate onto the cornea throughout the surgery. At the end of the surgery, the intraocular pressure is checked with fingers. This shows that viscote still remains on the corneal endothelium. Since it is not necessary to additionally wet the cornea, no moisture is retained and the surgery has been successfully performed, even for the deep-set eye. Thank you. When the eye of a pig was used, the visibility of lens was maintained without loss of moisture for about 30 minutes in this state. A time period of 30 minutes would permit completion of surgery on a patient with cataract without a complication. This method was applied to 37 patients with cataracts who underwent surgery at our hospital. In all the cases, the visibility of lens was successfully maintained without loss of moisture during surgery. This shows the state observed 30 minutes later. The cornea is not dried. As a precaution for the wet shell technique, perfusate should not be strongly applied to the surface of the viscote layer as is usually done. The part to which perfusate has been applied would be depressed and the viscote layer would become non-uniform. As a result, the visibility would deteriorate or air bubbles would be caught in the viscote layer. Once air bubbles are caught, they would not easily leave the viscote layer. This situation looks like the one experienced in the soft shell technique. Then, can any other material other than viscote, for example, Helon, be used for this purpose? Viscote is dispersive, while Helon is cohesive. When viscote is dropped, it will uniformly spread flat, while the dropped Helon will not uniformly spread, but remain in the dropped shape. This video picture shows how Helon is used in the actual surgery. As you can see, Helon takes an elevated shape and does not become uniformly flat. It easily slips off the cornea and cannot form a beautiful wet shell. Now let's look at the characteristics of viscote for self-closure of the corneal wound. In the course of performing surgery by the wet shell technique on several patients, I noticed that there was a tendency of showing better self-closure than in the case where no viscote was applied to the corneal epithelium. A pig's eye was used to examine this tendency. Two incisions were made in the pig's cornea using an 18-gauge needle. One was coated with viscote. Subsequently, air was injected through the puncture made in the anterior chamber. I checked to see which incision air would leak from first. As shown here, air leaked from the layer that was not coated with viscote. After viscote was well washed off, the other incision was coated with viscote. In this case, the same result was also obtained. As expected, this experiment showed that viscote had an action of sealing the corneal incision. As shown here, in practice, the incision in the cornea and the puncture in the anterior chamber are coated with viscote before the surgery is finished. This video picture shows a slit lamp image of the cornea that was observed 15 minutes after the wet shell technique was performed. As you can see from this image, the layer of viscote remained on the cornea. At our hospital, surgery is performed by the wet shell technique without dropping perfusate on about 500 patients annually. Successful surgical results have been obtained with the visibility maintained without additionally wetting the cornea during surgery. The wet shell technique not only allows performing cataract surgery efficiently, but also has an action of protecting the corneal epithelium and an efficacy in healing wounds. I would like to further study these effects in the future.